Hello everyone, welcome back to our exclusive interview series with the Pillars of Sydenham College. Today we have our Honorable Dr. Hassan sir with us, who's got more than 14 years of experience in the college, being the VBR coordinator and also the placement coordinator.
Hi.
Hello sir, thank you for being here and giving us your valuable time.
Good afternoon all, and thank you very much.
Yes. So to begin with, what are you liking the most about Sydenham College and what is the most challenging thing you faced being here?
What I like most about Sydenham College, very frankly to say that the day, first day of entry of my Sydenham College, 2007, 4th of August, somewhere around 11:15, I came to Sydenham College premises and I was very much in confused stage. How I am going to work in this Sydenham College, the premises is so small or something like that, because I came from the area Amravati and my college, King Edward College, which is now called as Vidarbha Mahavidyalaya, VMB College, one of the biggest college. It is having the area of 164 acres and from botany department to chemistry department, home science department, we have to walk somewhere around from Sydenham College to Eros Talkies. This is the difference between one department to another department. And I was standing on that Simsri gate, and from there I went to take a circle from both the sides. I went to back side, then on the floor, and I thought that it's one of my VMB one department. This is a botany department. It is a Sydenham College building. Fine. Then I went inside. I took my chair in room number 15, that was my first office for MBA Yashwantrao Chavan Open University MBA department. I took the charge and from there my journey started. As the day passed, I got many challenges facing the students, then facing the mentality of the public here, because the area from where I came, it was having a very different set of mindset. Students are very different, near about 180 degree of change. And here the set of mindset of the student is very different, which initially for a few days I was to adjust that thing. But touch wood, fortunately, I got accustomed. First of all, I adjust myself with this system, and automatically things start running. Then I took the charge of BBI department in 2010 at the strength of 44 student. Then for a few days I didn't work at all, whatever the, and you can say administrative work, I didn't do a single work. I just keep on observing each and everything. I just used to go take the lectures, observe the students, then used to sit in the cabin and start thinking how to make the things work out. Because what I have seen throughout Bombay, that Jain KCHR, then GTV, another Guru Tej Bahadur Singh, that Khalsa College, then Rizvi College, wherever the BBI banking and students classes was there, they were not having more than 40 students out of 60 seats. And that was the biggest challenge for me. And it's my nature, inborn nature, ki wherever I sit and whatever I do, I want to do it in the best way, otherwise I will not do it. That is simple funda for me. I will be doing 100, giving 100%, and if I feel that I will not be able to give 100%, I will not take the charge only. I will not sit there only. So then for a few days I just design my strategy, how to take the things ahead. Then we started the event, then we started the marketing with my own way, as I used to do personally. And next year I got 60 seats. Then I went to see the university result. My good friends were there in the university. I discussed with them how the things work out in the university, Bombay University and all. With the professors, I discussed many things, ki how to uplift the students. Because see, BCom is an established traditional course from generations. BMS, it is something, a very elite course. BAF and new courses were at that time, BAF was not introduced. BMS was there, then something management courses were there. But BBA were not to be seen anywhere. And fortunately, I fulfilled the target of 60 seats with my personal contacts and marketing and all. And as this government, this was the government college, I've been told that ki open marketing will not be done. So I do it with the chain networking way, with my own networks. Then I realized that ki I should be recognized by the university also. And how I will be recognized? There was only two way, that ki my student should top the university academically, and my student should represent the universities. Then only I will be recognized as a BBI department. Otherwise, nobody knows what is BBI department. Even in Sydney, they were not aware that ki BBI department exists. So I did extensive work on students. Personally, I used to observe each and every student. I have a tendency of forgetting the names, but I don't forget their faces. So I used to personally call them, I personally sit with them, discuss with them. And day by day, they start involving themselves more in the college. More in, they used to give me their personal times with me. I used to share my personal time with them. Even after college, I used to sit at Marine Drive. Daily from 6 to 7, 5 to 6, 7, I used to be there at Marine Drive with the students. Sharing their personal problems, sharing their views, college, how to go ahead. And that was the year when my first two students topped the Bombay University. After that, till 2018, I can boast myself that BBI department has topped the university, Bombay University, academically from all the Bombay University other colleges. And you can check the results also. That was the happiest moment for me. And it has got that I should always keep on doing this. And I used to push, I used to target the students, how many students, these are the good talented students, okay fine. I used to personally observe them. And as you people know that, ki little bit my words are very much harsh, but it is for the benefit of the student. And it is said that, ki Hasan sir, jitto ko daatte hai, ya jiske piche pade rehte hai, sab jo aage jaake top mein jata hai, wo ek, yani ki wo kya bolte, lucky charm jaisi wali baat hai. Aur jisko Hasan sir baat hi nahi karte, dekhte hi nahi, samjho chale gaya, usse bhi chhod diya unhone samjho. But we don't discriminate the student. But only thing is that ki, if I am giving you 110%, not 100%, 110, 120%, 200% in the students, I need at least 10% from the student. Then only I can accept. If you are not ready to accept, then I can't help you. So that was the day I started growing the department size, increasing the strength of the student, and touch wood, the day came after 2-3 years only where I have to go for additional seats. And at that time Kagalkar madam was there, principal Kagalkar, Dr. Kagalkar madam was there, and I went to them with Shete sir ki sir mujhe additional seat chahiye, aisa university provision hai aur apun le sakte kya. To madam sarcastically boli, Hasan BBI mein admission additional seat chahiye kya? Mala, yes madam. Bole, theek hai. And they have given me the letter for the request to the registrar of Bombay University, and we got the first additional seat. And that was the first time, and till this date, we have taken additional seats. Then we go for the second division. We started a second division. Lot of colleges have approached me, as they are, all knows me very well personally also, ki how you are managing BBI, that ki you are not handling only one division, you are increasing the division also and with additional seats, what's the things? They asked me to come and give lecture to their students. I went there, I gave the lecture, that is a different thing. But I have involved and I have given my, not 100%, you can say 1000% to this institution, because Sydenham has a very different aura. First, you don't enter in the college, but you enter in the college and you absorb the energy of the college. Na, the college will not leave you. this is the beauty, and this is something you can say a charm or a aura, you can say, or in Marathi or Hindi you can say the vastu of this institution or the building, where you get attached. And I am little bit an emotional kind of person. I get involved too much in a very short time. So I thought that this is my place where I earn my bread and butter. So what all qualities which I am having, I should give it, because my inspiration was that ki, for personal, for me, I was an IPS guy. My uncle was assistant police commissioner in Bombay. My family is from all the police department and armed forces. And I also thought that ki, I should go in IPS or Indian Forest Services, because I love too much the animals and all, flora and fauna. I'm used to it. You have seen all my status and every time you can see. But unfortunately, due to some reasons, I couldn't make up. And I landed in this institution, in this field. as a student, I was totally 180 degree different. I used to be very rowdy. I used to do the gang wars. I used to do all sort of notorious things. So I know what is the problem student will face in future. So I am having that personal experience, not a someone said or oral experience or virtual experience or bookish experience of the other side of the life that I have lived. So I share my direct example with the student. But if you are doing like this, you are going to face this thing. So that somehow get impact with the students. And there are very stories attached to me with this college. I have many students who have gone in so much depression that they were about to live their life only. And this is a fact. I am not going to name the student, but touch wood, till today, not daily, but on every birthday of mine, every birthday without failing, wherever they are, they will come and touch my feet. Because I have given them a new hope of life. They have lost the hope. So I have not served this institution academically, but also to the student on a personal level. Till that time you see me on sitting on the chair in the college, I do all the professional work, what all I can. But once I move outside, there are hundreds of students, many students who have their personal issues. They come and ask my guidance, ask my help, and what all resources I have given it to them to solve their problem. So this is how Sydenham has given me a sense of satisfaction. Sydenham College has given me a work satisfaction. Sydenham student has given me love and affection and respect. That is what the most I need. They have given me the respect. And in return, I have given them my whole time and whole life, you can say. I would have done much better in other institutions or other thing in the career if I have went out. Still, but I thought that there is a sense of social service, a world which we do. It is a responsibility of the individual person to serve their nation, their future generation. And I thought that this is my way of serving the nation, or you can say in the form of new generation. So my dear students, what all you can say, what Sydenham College experience, it's wonderful. And you cannot express in the words. You can express, you can see that what I feel from my gesture. I cannot express in the words. This wonderful experience. Students are very good. College is utmost wonderful and it's growing. And I pray that this institution should grow better and best throughout the globe.
Absolutely, sir. We all of us have seen the tremendous changes you've brought ever since you've come here. You started from the scratch and now we've got the extra batches. So just adding on to what you said, what are some things or programs or changes you would like to make in the college that would elevate the branding and reputation of the same?
But all the changes, brands or programs. So see, this is a very vast question which cannot be defined, or you cannot say ki I can answer it, because I have to go with a very elaborated way. In a nutshell, I will say that ki don't bring any program which is only for the sake of name. First see whether that program will benefit the students and how it will benefit the students in the future and in the present. Our Sydenham students, I have seen 50% come from the mediocre family, 70% comes from the mediocre family, and they are born and brought up in such an environment, very close environment, where they are closely related to the family and their families are working, so they are closely attached to their friends. This is how what Bombay environment is, and what all they have the exposure is what their other friends has given to them.
Absolutely.
They have not seen the hardship of life, because Bombay is a economic metropolitan city, a city of economic background. But it is not like that ki the student will always remain in Bombay. You never know where the destiny will take you. I was the person who has invested my maximum time, my childhood in Bombay, and I have prayed that I should never return to Bombay. This was my praying, that I should never come back to Bombay. But my destiny had brought me to Bombay only. So you don't know. So see that that program should help them wherever they will go. It should be a fruitful program, not designed by any person just for the sake of name. Because student doesn't know what you are serving, what you are giving them on plate, they don't know. They will just go by your words. But in future, if that thing is not favorable for them, which you know better, that will be the waste, criminal waste of their valuable time and your resources. In the nutshell, I am saying this. There are thousands of programs, thousands of mushrooms like programs coming up daily. Just give a call and 100 people will come stand here with their catalogs with the programs. And how they will camouflage the programs, you will also not come to know. And how they will platter you and serve you, you will get entangled into their things. But whether that really that program worked, because in my statement make it very clear, you can re-earn your money what you have invested, but you will not get back your single minute of life which you have invested in that program, which is not worth for you. So bring those programs which are market oriented, not only market oriented, futurist oriented, because market changes every 2 years.
Right.
Every 2 years market change. So see that that program should have the base. That program, if the student has done this program in 2018, it should also help in 2025 also. At least they should have the base. That is the only thing. And there are thousands of programs like that. You have to just sit and do the research work or design it properly.
So next question, what do you think the students could do to, you know, make this college a better place than it is right now? And what is the vision for the college in the next 5 years?
First question is ki what is student can do. Second, what is the vision? The first and foremost is students should start attending the lectures and respecting the faculties. It is unfortunately very sad on the part of the student when they sit or stand in front of the faculties and they ask, sir, who is Professor XYZ? In front of that faculty only. Either it is a lacuna from the faculty side or from the student side. First of all, that has to be very much cleared. I am not blaming the students, neither I am blaming the system, I am blaming the faculties, but it is a very shameful part when a student asks the faculty, in front of the faculty, where is that faculty? So that means there is a gap from any of the side. That has to be first clear before we think something very big. First, bottom line, that has to be clear. Second, there is a small mindset of the student that अभी हमारी लाइफ जो है बहुत लंबी है और हम लोग अपने हिसाब से जाके कल जॉब ढूंढ लेंगे और अपने हिसाब से हम लाइफ जी लेंगे. क्योंकि आपको मैंने मेरे पहले उसमें बताया कि बॉम्बे जो है, बॉम्बे एक इकोनॉमिक कैपिटल हब है कि यहाँ पे अगर आप 10th पास भी है ना तो आपको कोई ना कोई जॉब तो मिल ही जाता है. डेटा ऑपरेटर का जॉब मिल जाता है एंड एटलीस्ट यू कैन अर्न 8,000 to 10,000. वो जो अंडरस्टैंडिंग स्टूडेंट के दिमाग में कि हम कुछ नहीं करेंगे 10,000 कमा लेंगे, वो पहले निकाल दो. आप पहले आप स्टूडेंट बन जाओ. आपको कुछ बड़ा काम करने के वास्ते नहीं बोल रहे हैं हम, ये बोल रहे हैं कि पहले आप स्टूडेंट, वाकई में स्टूडेंट बन जाओ. और स्टूडेंट कौन होता है? स्टूडेंट वो होता है अ रेसिपिएंट. स्टूडेंट इज अ रेसिपिएंट. मैं भी अगर किसी का स्टूडेंट हूं तो आई बिकम अ रेसिपिएंट. मैं जब कहीं से ज्ञान लेता हूं, क्योंकि पानी, देखा आपने पानी, पानी जब ऊपर से आसमान से नीचे आता है, नीचे से आसमान में कभी नहीं जाता है. तो नॉलेज भी वैसी है, नॉलेज ऊपर से नीचे आती है. तो आप एज ए स्टूडेंट कर जब एडमिट होते हो तो आपका काम है कि जो भी सामने वाला बोल रहा है या बता रहा है उसको रिसीव करना. अगर आप रिसीव नहीं कर सकते हो तो आप स्टूडेंट ही नहीं हो. एक महाभारत, सॉरी रामायण के अंदर में हर वक्त लोग कोट करते हैं, मैं भी अक्सर वो चीज को कोट करता हूं. जब रावण की डेथ हो रही थी, ही वॉज अबाउट टू डाई, ही वॉज लाइंग देयर, तो राम ने लक्ष्मण को बोला कि बोले रावण जो है वो भले असुर बोलो, दानव जो भी वो एक्स वाई जेड है, बट ना ही ऑन द लास्ट स्टेज, अभी वो मर जाएगा, मगर वो बहुत ज्यादा ज्ञानी है. आप जाके उससे ज्ञान ले लो, उसके लास्ट वर्ड्स के उसके ज्ञान ले लो. और लक्ष्मण गया, रावण ऐसा डेड बेड के ऊपर में था. लक्ष्मण जाके उसके सिर के पास में खड़ा हो गया और बोलने लगा कि हा मिस्टर रावण, अभी आप जा रहे हो और मेरे ब्रदर ने मुझे बोला है कि तुमसे नॉलेज ले लो, मुझे नॉलेज दो आप लास्ट वर्ड्स. तो रावण ने बोला एक काम कर, तू मेरे पैरों के पास में आके खड़े हो गया, बस इतना ही बोला उसने. लक्ष्मण वहां से निकल के वापिस आए, राम के पास में आए और फिर राम ने पूछा कि भाई क्या ज्ञान मिला तुझे? अरे बोले यार कुछ नहीं, बोले रावण के पास में मैं गया, उसने मुझे बोला कि तुम पैर के पास में खड़े हो जाओ, बस इतना ही बोला, बाकी कुछ भी ज्ञान नहीं दिया. और आपने तो बोले बहुत ज्ञानी है, बहुत ज्ञान देगा, ये करेगा. तो राम ने बोले कि बोले उसने ऑलरेडी तुमको ज्ञान दे चुका है. बोले मतलब कैसा? मैं नहीं समझा. तो फिर राम ने उनको बताया कि बोले देखो, जिंदगी में जब कभी तुम्हें कुछ चीज चाहिए ना, तो तुम किसी के सिर पे जाके मत खड़े रहो, उसके पैरों के पास में जाके खड़े रहो. यानी इसका मतलब क्या है? स्टैंड एज ए रिसिपिएंट. मगर हमारे स्टूडेंट क्या करते हैं? वो पैरेलल खड़े होते हैं. आप नो डाउट आप खड़े रहो हमारे पैरेलल, आप हमको आइडियाज दो, हमारी आइडियाज दो, बट हम क्या बता रहे हैं वो तो समझो, क्योंकि आप स्टूडेंट हो. यू आर नॉट द मेंटर, we are the mentor. Might be our knowledge will be somewhat little different from you, बट समथिंग विल बी देयर, ट्राई टू एब्जॉर्ब इट, अंडरस्टैंड इट. तो वो जो था कि राम ने उसको बताया कि लक्ष्मण जो तुमको पैर के पास में खड़े होने का बोला, उसने तुमको जिंदगी का ज्ञान ये दे दिया रावण ने कि जब कभी भी आपको कोई ज्ञान चाहिए या कुछ चीज चाहिए तो सामने वाले के सिर के पास में नहीं बोला जाता, एरोगेंटली नहीं मिला जाता है, रिक्वेस्ट से. और एज ए रिसिपियंट लो, यानी आप अपना माइंड को ओपन कर दो. अगर आपसे आप मुझे इंटरव्यू देने के वास्ते बुला रहे हो यहाँ पे और ऑलरेडी आपके माइंड में सेट है सब चीज, तो आप मेरा कभी इंटरव्यू ले नहीं पाओगे, कभी नहीं ले पाओगे, क्योंकि आपके पास में प्रिजिडाइज, योर माइंड विल बी प्रिजिडाइज, योर माइंड विल ऑलवेज बी ऑलरेडी बीन फिल्ड. अरे यार सर का ऐसा रिप्लाई आया, हमारा ऐसा रिप्लाई रहेगा करके, क्वेश्चन रहेगा करके, बी ओपन. तो स्टूडेंट का काम है कि अपने आपको एज ए रिसिपियंट बताएं, जो सामने वाला बताता है उसको समझ के ले, ना कि उसको मिसअंडरस्टैंड करके ले, देन ओनली यू कैन बी अ गुड स्टूडेंट. तो मैंने आपका पहला क्वेश्चन दे दिया कि स्टूडेंट क्या करे, आपको बहुत कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं है, पहले स्टूडेंट बन जाओ. फर्स्ट इज बिकम अ स्टूडेंट. सेकेंड, आप जिस काम के वास्ते आए हो, आपने एडमिशन लिया है एकेडमिक्स एजुकेशन, वो आपकी प्रायोरिटी होना चाहिए. उसके बाद में ऑल दोस एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज, दैट इज वाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज, जो कि जरूरी है आपके वास्ते बट एक्स्ट्रा, उसमें आप जाओ, अपने आप का होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट करो. जहां पे आपको प्रॉब्लम्स आता है तो वी हैव ऑल द रिनाउंड लर्नेड एंड इंटेलेक्चुअल फैकल्टीज, उनसे जाके आप सलाह मशवरा करो, गाइडेंस लो, एंड यू कैन ग्रो वेरी वेल. एंड फॉर्चुनेटली वी हैव द बिगेस्ट प्लेसमेंट सेल ऑफ साउथ बॉम्बे, नहीं महाराष्ट्र यू कैन से, डॉक्टर झरना मैडम शी इज हैंडलिंग दैट प्लेसमेंट. So, and you are fortunate that ki you are the student of BMS.
Absolutely.
So, you have the upper edge. All the students have the upper edge, but you are very much close. So, go and get your best jobs and fulfill your dreams of your parents. That is what. And for college, second question was?
What do you envision about the college in the next 5 years?
Next 5 years, no doubt, Sydenham College will grow like anything. Only is that we have the little bit difference between the private and the government, in being a government institute, that we have some rules, sort of regulations where we cannot move freely. But if that things has to be ruled out, so nobody can compare the Sydenham College today also. Forget about, I don't care for five years ahead. Today also nobody can match Sydenham College. I have taken lectures in topmost colleges of Bombay. But I've never found students like Sydenham College in other colleges. They are good, they are best. But there is a vast difference between the Sydenham students and other colleges students. I've seen many institutions with big buildings, but there the area, the aura of that institutions doesn't hold you back. Sydenham College holds you back. Many times you try to move out, but still that institutions hold you back. So definitely today also nobody can match the Sydenham College. We are giving the best placements, we are giving the biggest and the highest numbers of societies which no other college is having, and that is also full-fledged working. We are giving the results, topmost results. We have given the result to Bombay University also, and now we are giving the result to Homi Baba University also. And if you go in the market, 60% of KPMG, Deloitte, JP Morgan, Ernst & Young, maximum big companies, and near about every bank, ever name the private bank or government, SBI also, you will find Sydenham students. Because wherever I go, I find at least one single student who is calling me, sir, aap idhar kaise? So that is the beauty of the things. So forget about 5 years. nobody can match Sydenham now also. And as we have the dynamic principal, Dr. Dhure sir, who is keenly interested in developing this institution.
Absolutely.
God give him all the health and powers which he needs. Definitely, the changes he is trying to bring can be visibly seen. You can see it very visibly. This is not a words of flattering or boasting to anybody. This is an interview and I am opening my heart. Lot of drastic changes has been visibly seen, and definitely the way things are working out, we can see that key, the glory of Sydenham. We have already got that glory, but still we have lot of things to achieve, which we will definitely achieve in this regime.
Absolutely. So my last question to end this interview on a good note, what is that one moment from your journey here that if you could go back in time and you could relive it, then which moment would that be?
Really,
if you could go back in time.
Every other day I spend in the Sydenham College is a memory for me. You have seen many times after college I am sitting in the cabin.
Yes.
So I am just recollecting my memories. I have very, very, very beautiful memories attached to this college with my colleagues, with my students, because I have lived my major life with the students. I am still living with them. You will never find a day in the college there is no student in my cabin, or outside the college one or the two students are there with me from any of the department, but they are. So memories are there are not a single memory, there are hundreds of memories. And we have done NEC, we have done admissions, we have done extracurricular activities, we have done the events also, big conferences also, international conference, and every memory is a beautiful memory. There is no sad memories or harsh memories, but each and every memory is like that, ki I should do these things again. That is what I cannot precise it in a one word.
Thank you so much.
And my last is, I always wish that the Sydenham students should grow and bring the fame to their parents, their institution, and for themselves also. This is my best wishes.
Thank you so much. It's wonderful having you.
Thank you, dear.